Morning. Today's topic is asepsis and sterilization. Now, for us surgeons, aseptic techniques, you must have often heard the word aseptic techniques, right? So, aseptic techniques hota kya hai? Why is so much important ki hum ye asepsis pe itna dhyan dete? Often and often, tumne suna hoga that we are using the word kindly do anything using aseptic techniques. So, if you see this slide, which is so booming, that sepsis is an insult to a surgeon. A very professional and a passionate person who is a surgeon would be very much disturbed if you have operated a patient and the patient lands up with a pus discharging from the wound, right? Or you have done a simple IV access in a patient and the patient develops redness and phlebitis. You feel very upset about it because somewhere down the lane, some infection has entered into the patient, right? And any surgeon would never want ki uska patient would go home with some morbidity, with some unhappiness, right? So in a healthcare setup, it is extremely important ki hum patients ko, we give such facilities to the patient that they go home happily. How they go home happily? Is by whatever procedures hum karte hai, surgeons, whenever they do some procedure, be it a minor procedure, be it a major surgery, usme kya hona chahiye? Asepsis hona chahiye. Asepsis is a word which we use very colloquially. Hum bahut hi commonly a word use kar lete hai, but what actually it is something which is very technical and it should be followed technically. So, if you go through this, it is a set of specific practices and procedures which are performed carefully in controlled conditions, and our whole purpose of this is to minimize the infection or any form of contamination in the patient. Now, ye kaun karta hai? Asepsis is followed by, in our homes, we clean our homes, we dust our homes, but that is not asepsis, right? That is just a cleaning. But when we are working in a healthcare setup, the asepsis, aseptic precautions, that is, ye sare jo precautions hai ya procedures hai, they are to be done. Ab only the surgeon or only the clinician is not responsible for that. There are many other people who are involved so that we achieve asepsis, right? So these are the healthcare professionals. So who are those healthcare professionals? They are surgeons or the clinician. Then we have the nursing staff, the surgeon and the assistant of the surgeon, the residence doctors, and also the class 4 staff. Okay, they all, when they work in coordination, when they work in a particular set of manner, in a particular way, then we can achieve this asepsis. Because aapke teachers bolte hai ki liver abscess drain kiya, did you take aseptic measures? You say yes, we did aseptic measures. But what actually the whole set of aseptic measures is, that is extremely important for us as surgeons to understand, right? So the last line, if you see, one and all that get into the contact with the wound obligate to be sterile. One and all means, for example, aap ek minor procedure le lo. You are doing a minor surgery. ठीक है, उसमें यू आर द सर्जन, देर इज एन असिस्टेंट, देर इज एन नर्सिंग स्टाफ, ओके, देन देर इज अ सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स दैट दे आर यूजिंग, देर इज अ सेट ऑफ ड्रेप्स दैट हैव बीन पुट ऑन द पेशेंट, देन देर इज अ सर्वेंट स्टाफ हु इज मूविंग अराउंड टू हेल्प यू अराउंड. ऑल दीज पीपल, वेन दे वर्क इन अ कोऑर्डिनेटेड मैनर, वेन दे वर्क इन अ स्पेसिफिक मैनर, then and then only can you achieve the word asepsis. Asepsis should be the fourth word in our Bible of surgery, right? Because then and then only we will be able to give quality care to the patients, right? The trend is quality care to the patients. Now, iske saath saath, asepsis ke saath, we have certain words jo hum routinely use karte hai, but it has some technical meaning. Jaise asepsis means freeing whatever organism from all the microorganisms, contamination. Iske saath saath we come across the words antisepsis, disinfection and sterilization in our practice, right? So they are not interchangeable words. They have technically different meanings. Antisepsis means कोई भी लिविंग सरफेस को आप यू आर फ्रीइंग ऑफ माइक्रोऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक व्हेन यू आर पेंटिंग अ पेशेंट, ठीक है, सर्जरी से पहले व्हेन यू यूज सम सॉल्यूशन, ओके, बीटाडीन यूज किया या अल्कोहल यूज किया, व्हाटएवर यू यूज, दैट इज नोन एज एंटीसेप्टिक. व्हेन यू आर ड्रेसिंग अ वुंड यू यूज बीटाडीन, दैट इज एन एंटीसेप्टिक. सो व्हेन यू फ्री अ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम माइक्रोऑर्गेनिजम्स इट इज एंटीसेप्सिस. Disinfection is when you are cleaning your OT table with, for example, 1% hypochlorite, right? That is disinfection. When you are cleaning your OT instruments, okay, that is disinfection. You don't paint a patient with betadine and say, I have disinfected. That is, you have used an antiseptic. Okay, so disinfection is used for inanimate things. And when you use the word antisepsis, it is when you are dealing with life, with living organisms. Sterilization is also basically for inanimate things, but it is a one step higher than disinfection. In disinfection, you do not free the surface or instrument from spores. You kill viruses, you kill bacteria, you kill fungi, you kill mycobacteria. But you do not kill spores. But in sterilization, you kill or you destroy each and everything, including spores. Okay? So these are the basic terminology differences, which every surgeon or every clinician, in fact, should understand. Okay? So moving forward, we go, why this asepsis? Why did we come with the concept of asepsis? So whenever we understand something, it is important to know the history, what happened. So in 18th century, what used to happen, that those females who delivered babies, it was found that puerperal sepsis was very rampant in them. They used to get infected, get very major infections and die. So this gentleman Ignaz, he found that, why? Because deliveries was conducted by medical people who were moving all around in the hospital, coming from the mortuaries, coming from other work. And there was no concept of cleaning hands, washing hands before doing a delivery. So he introduced the concept that prior to doing deliveries, you should wash your hands. Okay? Simple concept of washing hands had the inception at that time. Later on, as progress happened, this Lister, he's a very, very, very famous name. He used to do some procedures and he found out that by applying carbolic acid, phenol, on the patient, prior to any procedure, when he did it, the infection rates went down. So there came the insight of an antiseptic. Okay. These were the findings. See, if you see the pictures in the books of 18th century, what happens is, you will find people who have been those ghastly pictures of a surgeon with a knife in the hand, people around them, they are in their routine clothes, there are 10-15 people inside, right? So this was the picture. So actually, surgery was performed like that. Instead of anesthetist, there used to be 10 people holding the patient, right? So this is the inception. Now how surgery evolved and how antisepsis and asepsis evolved. So this, in brief, you should know the history so that you understand the significance of what level of asepsis and antisepsis and sterilization and disinfection we are following at present. So puerperal sepsis, hand washing came into practice. Then that concept of carbolic acid and cleaning the patient's area of surgery came into practice. Then what happened is this Dr. Lawson, he found out that, as I said, there was a picture of so many people surrounding the patient and operating. So he decided that let us keep the people minimum. Let us operate in a specific room where there are few people and the movement of the people is restricted. and then they got still better results. Initially, surgeries used to be done in open, you know, anywhere, कहीं पे भी. 10 लोग, 15 लोग इकट्ठे हुए, knife लिया, candle पे गरम किया, and started. This is the history. Yes, if you see the history of surgery, this is what was done. So then came the concept of operating in a particular room with few people, restricting the entry of the people, right? And then William Halstead is a very pioneer name, Halstead surgery, Halstead mastectomy. Anna, you've heard of that radical Halstead mastectomy. So he's that fellow. He introduced that, theek hai, room mein to operate karo, few people ke saath operate karo, but wear specific uniforms. Us operation karne se pehle, you will wear this dress and you will wear gloves. ठीक है, वो ग्लव्स क्यों पहनना शुरू किया? बिकॉज वन ऑफ हिज स्टाफ गॉट सम एलर्जी टू कार्बोलिक एसिड व्हाइल पुटिंग इट. सो ही आस्क्ड द गुडियर रबर कंपनी, गुडियर की गुडियर टायर्स बनाता है, उस रबर कंपनी को बोला कि मुझे ऐसी कोई चीज दो जो हाथ में पहन सकते हैं. सो देयर केम द ग्लव्स. सो ग्रेजुअली इन द सर्जिकल प्रैक्टिस ये सारी चीजें आई. नाउ considering the present situation, you understand how it evolved, with what problems ये सारी चीजें आई, and now how हम casually जब use करते हैं, तो दो century पहले कितनी problems हुई थी और ये कैसे कैसे ये चीजें evolved हुई. So with ये सब चीजें आने के बाद what happened is the situation improved, lesser patients were getting infected, and the results were getting better. And then finally over the years the concept of asepsis. Now, when we use the word asepsis, so where do we use it? Commonly surgical wards mein, right? Whenever you are doing some procedures, okay? Small procedure, some Foley's catheterization karte ho, so often you have heard your consultant say, please use aseptic precautions. Hai na? So, tum mundi hila dete hai, hum sab mundi hila dete hai, but what are those aseptic precautions? Kahan se shuru hote hai? That means see. Simple IV access karte ho, use aseptic precautions. What are those aseptic precautions? You go in the radiology department for a liver abscess drainage, for a percutaneous nephrostomy. Supposed to use aseptic precautions. Aseptic precaution is not just painting the patient and wearing the gloves and inserting. Okay? That a true surgeon, a professional, passionate surgeon would never do that. Because aseptic precautions is a huge complex of things which has to be followed. And of course, in the operation theatres, जहाँ पे तुम maximum so-called aseptic precautions लेते हो, ठीक है ना? Wards में तो casually हो जाता है, but बाकी हम लेते हैं, तो हम सबसे ज़्यादा aseptic precautions लेते हैं operation theatres में. How we'll see? So aspects of aseptic technique practices. Asepsis is actually a complex of actions. इसमें इतनी चीजें आती हैं. Barriers, patient and equipment preparation, environmental controls and contact guidelines. अब ये क्या है? I will very simply explain you. For example, let us take the simple example of operating a patient in the operating room. What is your goal when you are operating the patient? That the patient is cured of his surgery and patient goes home on the 7th or the 8th day after stitch removal, without any pus discharge, without any complications, right? That is naturally the goal and aim of every surgeon. But uske liye, would you like to operate him in the ward? No. You would want a proper operation theater. Why? Because the operation theater has a sterile environment, right? Sterile environment kyun hai? For example, if we take the operation theaters of our institute, in the OT, we have HEPA filters, filtration system. Okay. इसमें क्या होता है कि when जो operating table के ऊपर जो panel है, उसके अंदर there are HEPA filters kept and there is a laminar airflow, right? So HEPA filters में जो भी microns होते हैं, जो भी organisms होते हैं, वो filter out हो जाते हैं and clean air comes on the operation table and laminar होके side के out से निकल जाती है. तो जो area है patient surgery का, that is the cleanest area. वहाँ पे cleanest air आती है and that goes away, right? So it is free from microorganisms. So द एनवायरमेंटल फैक्टर, एनवायरमेंटल कंट्रोल, जी इसी ऑर्डर में नहीं डिस्कस कर रहे, एनवायरमेंटल कंट्रोल्स, सो वी रिक्वायर द एनवायरमेंट शुड बी फ्री ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स, राइट? सो ओटीज, सपोजिंग यहाँ हेपा फिल्टर्स नहीं है, जहाँ लेमिनार फ्लो नहीं है, वहां रेगुलरली ओटीज आर फ्यूमिगेटेड, फ्यूमिगेशन बाय फॉर्मल्डिहाइड या किसी भी तरह, ताकि एयर के अंदर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स नहीं हो. See, to understand asepsis, you have to understand that microorganisms are present everywhere, in the air, in the hands of the operator, as well as on the patient, as well as on your assistants who are helping you. So, every area when you make it relatively free of organisms, then you have achieved asepsis. So, major surgeries karni hoti hai, ya important, ya jahan bahut invasion hai, वो प्रोसीजर्स हम वार्ड ऑपरेशन थिएटर्स में करते हैं, बिकॉज वी गेट अ रिलेटिवली फ्री माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्री एनवायरमेंट इन द स्टराइल जोन ऑफ द ओटी, राइट? जोन्स ऑफ द ओटी तो पता है ना, एक बाहर आउटर जोन होता है, फिर उसके बीच में क्लीन जोन होता है जहां अपनी रिकवरी होती है और जहां यू चेंज द पेशेंट्स, एंड देन यू हैव द स्टराइल जोन, ओके, वेयर नोबडी एंटर्स एक्सेप्ट दोज हु आर इन देयर सर्जिकल क्लोथ्स, हु आर इन देयर सर्जिकल फुटवेयर, राइट? And then you have the right, the operation zone, that is the absolutely sterile zone, your theaters, जहाँ पे HEPA filters है, जहाँ की filtration system है, ताकि environment is microorganism free. So that is the asepsis में important है कि आपने अपने पास microorganism free environment हो relatively. So that is our operation theaters. Okay. Now we are talking of surgeries just now. Then we'll come to the ward procedures. Then second is that patient and equipment preparation. Whenever the patient goes in the OT, do we tell you to do pre-operative preparation of the patient? Clipping of the hair, putting a betadine scrub, usse pehle asking the patient to take a bath, okay, on the day of the, on the morning of the surgery. So these are the situations which decreases the load of the microorganisms. Patient ki skin pe bhi to apna flora hone wala hai. He has to have his bath. That will decrease cleaning is extremely important. So patient, ये सारी चीजें when we don't consider as patients, जब अपने surgery से पहले when residents also don't take care of all these things, then ultimately somewhere down the lane you are breaching the chain of asepsis, which is not right. So the patients have to have a bath. You have to give a pre-operative skin preparation to the patient in form of some antiseptic solution which you do it, right? In the morning prior to surgery. So that is patient preparation. Then equipment preparation. So the instruments that we are going to use are going to be sterilized, right? We'll come to a bit sterilization. So sterilization is a component of asepsis, okay? Asepsis is not equivalent to sterilization, but sterilization is a must to ensure asepsis, isn't it? We use sterilized instruments. We'll come to sterilization a little bit later on. So equipment mein, instrument should be sterilized or disinfected, at least disinfected, right? And patient mein should be prepared, right? Then, so environment we understood. The second part, patient and equipment, we understood. The third part is barriers. You, the surgeon, okay, has also organisms on your hand. You are not free of organisms just because you are the master of the ceremony. That doesn't make you free of organisms. So you also prepare yourself in some way for that, to not to break that chain of asepsis. You take a proper hand wash. Patient ko bathe karne ko bola. Obviously, we would have come and bathed, but now we have to do a more important thing. So, we do a proper hand wash and scrub. See, understand, plain hand, it has reached to the commonest person today in India because of the corona effect. But when we scrub in the OT, there is, you must have seen pictures and you must be following it also quite some time. All the ends should be properly clean, okay? Because normally, tum aise 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 karke, you wear your gown, what happens is there are so many areas on your hand where the organisms have lodged. You have worked in the wards, you have touched something, you are having plenty of organisms on your hand. So that proper technique of hand washing and proper duration of 2 to 5 minutes 2 minutes minimum should be followed by the surgeon. Otherwise, you are breaking the chain of resepsis, right? It should be in this position. You should be washing all the areas properly, scrubbed and cleaned with your antiseptic solution or your soap. The water should be dripping down the elbows. Then you're supposed to dry your hands. Jo hota nahi hai. After cleaning ke baad, dry karte hai hands ko. So there is a towel which is kept there, sterile towel, by which you dry all the parts of your hands. Then some surgeons may prefer putting in sanitizer, jo bolte hai, ya antiseptic, jo bhi hai, sometimes. And then you don your gloves. Then you wear your gown. Wearing the gown is also extremely important. You don't hold the gown from the outer side when you are operating. You hold it from the inner side. Your hands never cross the shoulders. It is your assistant who will pull back your gown. So these are small things. You don't wear your gown and you pull it like this. Never do that. You're breaking the chain of asepsis. So your assistant does that. Completely cover your gown from behind. Okay? The gowns which we have in our operation theatres are not so excellent because there is a breach. But it should be completely wrapping your back part also. So it has to be covering. So that's a sterile thing. Then you wear your gloves. Again, gloves have to be worn in a particular manner. You can't just, jaise aap hold karte ho, dono ko aur pehen lete ho. Not like that. First, you know very well the technique of holding the gloves. Right? It is first glove kaise pehenne ka, second glove. So there is a technique. We'll not go into the details just now. You wear your gloves. Then you go to the operation, wherever the field is. Understand one thing. Only neck to waist is the sterile zone. Please understand that. For a surgeon, only neck to waist, this much area is your sterile zone. Beyond that is not sterile. So this area should not come in contact with any unsterile thing. Okay? Your assistant comes and touches you peeche surgery dekhne ke liye. It makes you unsterile. Niche ka part sterile nahi hai. Your hand should not cross. Aise khade reh gaye tum. Gone. You have breached this chain of asepsis. You have to understand only it is this. You cannot put your hands in your axilla like this. Your hands should be in this position. Okay? So these are the things which are extremely important when you want to give an aseptic procedure to the patient. Okay. So, same thing with your assistants and your ancillary staff. It is only this area. Then you paint the patient and you drape the patient. Drapes mein kab break hoti hai asepsis ki chain? Jab when your drapes are touching the ground. Please remember, when you drape your towels on the patient, they should not touch the ground. Kabhi towel is so long, lamba hota hai, to wo ground ko touch karta hai. There and there your sterilized towel is gone. It should be hanging. Never keep it such that it is touching the ground. These are extremely, according to you, many very small things but extremely important. These are things jo baad mein patient ko infections hote and we blame it on ki dressing kharab tha, patient kharab tha, patient ko already peritonitis tha. No. We as healthcare professionals should understand that we can't break that change. So that towel should not be touching the ground. Okay? Proper screen should be there so that your anesthetist doesn't come on. Anesthetists have a habit of seeing. Koi bhi us taraf se. They keep on coming into your sterile zone. So that zone around the patient, jiska surgical area hai aur jahan when the surgeons and the assistants are standing, that is the only sterile zone once the surgery starts. So please be careful of these things. These are extremely important when we talk of aseptic precautions. Okay? We wash our hands for 2 seconds. We hold the gown in whatever way we want to wear. We wear the gloves in whatever we want to go. On the way we are touching something. That is not asepsis. That cannot be a passionate professional doing this. Okay? And we have to committedly, sincerely and regularly follow this. Right? So that amounts to asepsis when you are dealing with the patient. Of course, then whatever precautions we take during surgery. But this is the aseptic chamber. Okay. Contact guideline means, yahi, as I said, that somebody cannot come and touch you from behind just because to peep into the surgery. There has to be a distance maintained. It cannot be touched. You cannot give, or somebody from the unsterile cannot give you something in your hand. You cannot give to that person in the hand. Supposing instrument is not working. So I give and the unsterile person, my assistant, holds it. No, you have to just drop it. Okay, these are small things. But when you are also holding, you are breaking the chain of asepsis. Very minute things, but extremely, extremely important. Okay? Now, when you are doing ward procedures, isme se kitni cheeze follow karte hai? See, ward procedures are done jisme skin breach nahi hoti. Aise hi procedures hum ward mein karenge. Right? Major skin breach nahi hai. Jaise ki you want to put in a catheter, or you want to put in a liver abscess drain karna hai. To usme, it's quite possible that you do not get a microorganism free environment. That's fine. But baki jitne bhi, whatever I said, that has to be strictly followed. You have to wash your hands. Do you wash your hands for 2 minutes? No. Do you wear a gown? No. Do you wear gloves properly? No. At the same time, isme ek important cheez hai, when someone you take from outside during the sterile zone, to, supposing a stapler, you have asked for a stapler or a suture material. It is extremely important for the assistant that he sees ke us mein koi breach nahi hai. Stapler ke pack mein, if there is a breach or it is partially open, then that once again, and if it is given to you, the chain of asepsis is broken, isn't it? So it is extremely important for the entire team to be following the process and the practice of asepsis. So assistant feel, I am just standing in the OT, what is my job? No, your job is extremely important. You will be the pertinent person in breaking the chain of asepsis when you open something that was already breached in sterility, right? So everybody has to be extremely careful when we are dealing with aseptic procedures, right? Person who is giving has to see ki isme koi breach nahi hai, isme koi tear nahi hai. It's extremely important. Otherwise, the chain would have broken. Okay. So, when you are doing minor procedures also, see, aisa nahi hona chahiye for the surgeon, it should not be God saves the patient despite us. Minor procedures mein, when you are putting a suprapubic catheter, yeah, when you are putting a liver abscess also, you are entering into an organ. Whenever any invasive procedure is done, you have to be extremely, extremely cautious aseptic precautions, and especially when you are doing central venous catheterizations in the wards, you are directly putting the catheter in the heart, right, in the superior vena cava. The tip is going to be lodged in the superior vena cava. So God forbid if the infection, if you have broken the asepsis chain, and if the infection happens to enter into the superior vena cava, then from there patient will go into septicemia, which is a very, very dreadful complication of central venous catheterization. So even while dressing a patient of central venous catheterization, you have to be extremely careful in washing your hand, changing your gloves. Someone else opens the dressing for you. You clean it properly. While putting injections into central venous catheterization, you are supposed to clean that area with spirit, 70% alcohol. Okay. At least you disinfect that area. You may not sterilize the area, but you disinfect the area and then only you put in your injections. So these are things which is expected and we should be doing as healthcare professionals. This is the way, because patients look upon you. This is a healthcare institute. You are supposed to do all these things and with conviction. So this is asepsis. Now, asepsis and sterilization and disinfection are two terminologies which are a part of asepsis, right? Now, you got some idea, asepsis is not equal to sterilization. But sterilization and disinfection is important in maintaining the chain of asepsis. I hope that point becomes clear to you. Sterilization, see, I will not go too much into the details of sterilization. Sterilization mein we have all the instruments that come, which are required, whether in the wards, whether in the operation theatres, they are sterilized. Now, sterilization can be by autoclaving, it can be by ETO. We have a CSST department. CSST department is Central Sterile Services Department. In every hospital, such a department is there. So, wahan pe bhi centrally, all the instruments are sterilized properly. Then they are given by a, they are given to the respective areas where required. So, we have these various means of sterilization. Sterilization is that the instrument is absolutely free from all the microorganisms, including spores. And disinfection, when do we use disinfection? Sometimes, we may not use it in our institute, but sometimes you have multiple surgeries. Okay, you may be working in a CHC, you have multiple surgeries and the instruments are limited. So what you can do is chemical disinfection. So there is 2% glutaraldehyde or OPA. In that, you clean the instruments and then you immerse it completely, the instruments, for a period of 20 to 25 minutes. When you do disinfection, it is absolutely important to remember that there is a duration for which you are supposed to keep the instruments. Even in sterilization, as you know, sterilization is at a particular temperature, 15 pounds per square inch pressure for 30 minutes, flash sterilization hai, toh fir for 5 minutes. So, is tarah se, duration is important. So, similarly, in disinfection, aisa nahi ki you dip it in Sidex and after 5 minutes you remove it and you feel it's a magic. No, you have to dip it for 20 minutes for disinfection. Okay, if you want to use this chemical for sterilization, you have to leave the instruments for 6 hours. So, then it will become free of spores also. But if you want rapidly, I have supposing only 2 sets of laparoscopy and I have 5 surgeries in waiting, okay, then what do I do is, I clean the instruments. Prior to disinfection, cleaning is very important. Prior to sterilization also, cleaning is very important. Cleaning is manual cleaning of the instruments. That is, there should be no blood, there should be no tissues on the instrument. Otherwise, if you do not clean your instrument and you send it to sterilization or disinfection, then your purpose is not solved. So, in the CSSD department, as you must be knowing, there is a ultrasonic cleaner or mechanical. Pani ka pump marke sare instruments ko clean karte hai. Cleaning of blood, tissue, debris. Okay. And there might be an enzymatic cleaner bhi hota hai, ultrasonic cleaners. Jisme at a particular temperature, wo instruments half an hour tak shake hote hai. Theek hai? Sweet cleans. So, jo blood tissue, uske saath if you send the instruments, then even if it is a packed instrument coming, then you have not sterilized your instrument. So, that is once again very pertinent in the chain of asepsis. So, you understand, asepsis is not only the onus of the clinician or the surgeon. There are many people who may be responsible for this asepsis, right? And everybody has to work in coordination and with sincerity. So, we have asepsis. Is it clear? So, asepsis and sterilization are basically not the same thing. Okay? Asepsis is a whole process. It is process of multiple things. Cleaning, the OT, there should be an OT environment, there should be antisepsis, there should be sterilization of instruments, there should be proper assistant nursing staff who should be well dressed properly in the code of conduct in which it should be. Whereas sterilization is what? Freeing the instruments or whatever, the OT from organisms. Asepsis is a complex thing, no? You have so many factors involved in asepsis. Sterilization is simple. Simple means ki aapne instrument ko de diya, autoclave ho gaya, ya ETO ho gaya, ya plasma ho gaya. So, it's relatively simple. And asepsis employs a combination of techniques, right? You are you're hand washing, you're wearing sterile clothes, you're putting antiseptic on the patient, your assistant is helping you, your OT environment should be clear. So, it's a complex thing after which you achieve asepsis. Whereas sterilization mein toh there are various methods, but sterilization is just sterilization. So, they cannot be used interchangeably. they are two things different. Take home message in asepsis is the entire system has to work properly. Okay. Otherwise, you feel when a question is asked you, did you take aseptic techniques? Tum yes bol dete ho. But for yes ke piche, you as the master of ceremony is the surgeon. So he or she has to monitor ki haan, I have taken proper precautions. But at the same time, does my ancillary staff properly don't, whether they have taken precautions, whether I have an environment that is proper. So if you have the knowledge of all this, you can monitor. You alone cannot ensure asepsis. Or supposing someone has given you an instrument that was already breached from the packet, then also you cannot ensure asepsis. So saying yes, I maintained asepsis is a huge responsibility. Okay? And your eyes will not see what your mind doesn't know, and vice versa. Right? So you should be very aware of these things, that I am supposed to manage asepsis and I am supposed to monitor the system. So I want to manage asepsis. And ultimately, as I said in my first slide, sepsis is a serious insult to the surgeon. I personally as a surgeon feel extremely disturbed if my patient's wound is infected, or if my patient gets some hospital acquired infection in form of a thrombophlebitis because of an IV access, or a wound infection if I have operated to. So when you reach that stage of sensitivity, then you automatically will start following all the aseptic precautions. Okay? So it is something which you have to understand, introspect, train yourselves, and please understand that each time it has to be done like that. Not because I am doing a simple IV access, so I'll just wear the gloves, I'll not wear the gloves, and I'll put it. That sincerity should come, that each time, each patient is extremely important. And I have to follow these precautions at whatever. See, if it's a minor procedure, of course, you do not wear a gown and you wear this, and depending on the procedures. But finally, asepsis is taking all the precautions so that you do not let the microorganisms enter into the patient. Okay? And the patient goes home happily. That is our purpose. Okay? Thank you so much. Thank you, Girish Bhai.